Hi, I'm Sam Foster with Keysight Technologies. I'm an R&D engineer. And today we're going to be looking at the IEC61000-3-2 measurements, harmonic measurements, on the IntegraVision Power Analyzer PA2203. Now this is going to be a very useful feature if you have some sort of device that is that you're trying to see will be compliant with the IEC standard and see what the harmonics look like. So first of all, I've got kind of a basic setup right now. You'll want to click on Analyze, and it will take you, if you're not already in the harmonics test, you can click here and get to the harmonics test. Now the IEC 61000 is a current harmonics test. So to be able to do this test, you're going to have to switch your source to a current. I'll go ahead and do that here. And you can see the frequency I've got going on is not exactly 60 hertz, so there's a place for you to put exactly what frequency you're working with. And right now I put in 59.8 hertz. So you can see we have a sidebar here showing your THD and a table view with the harmonic number, the frequency, the value in RMS, and then you can see the limits and margin and status are all blank right now. That's because I haven't started the test quite yet. So to do that, I'm going to click on Settings, and I'll go to the IEC Standards button. Now there are four different classes of IEC standards. There's A, B, C, and D. And you should choose the class of test for the type of device that you're testing. So I'm going to go ahead and show you maybe a little bit of each one. So for class A, you can see the test reruns, and I get all of my different harmonics up to the 40th harmonic. And you can see that I have nice green for passing, and you now have the limit, the allowable harmonic limit, and the margin of which you passed. Going on to the class B, it recalculates, and you get something pretty similar. Now class C, you can start seeing some failure in the harmonics. And up here you can see how many harmonics you actually failed. So that count is going up as the same waveform is going into the box. And it also, the third harmonic for class C uses the power factor to determine the limit. Going on to class D, you get the most amount of columns here. You get not only the same RMS limits and margin from the other tests, but then you have a milliamps per watt value, a milliamps per watt limit, a margin, and the total status of failing or passing. Now you may want to look at your harmonics in a few different ways. So if I go to my display key here, you can either look at it in a table view, or you can also look at your harmonics in bar chart view, which is a little bit more visually easy to see what's going on here. And if you really wanted to, you could look at both of them at the same time. The scroll harmonics button is just a nice, easy navigational tool. Once you click on it, this knob is now mapped to the harmonics. And as I move them around, both the table and the chart are moving to the corresponding harmonic of interest. And that's all I've got for you on the IEC 61000. Thank you for watching.